Hi everybody, my name is Diane. I'm doing a video about IMATS New York 2018. If you're not really familiar with IMATS, it's the International Makeup Artist Trade Show where like a lot of different brands go there, different vendors to sell their products, sometimes at like a discounted price. They also have like different speakers and stuff there. I personally just like going because I like to hoard makeup and that's basically it, to get some deals. And I usually go with my friend Stephanie. This is the second year that we're going. I know you're looking for something less. Oh, you want some me so bad. You want some me so bad. Come get this body. You want some me so bad. Okay, to start off, when we got there, they opened at like 10 a.m. We got there like 9, kind of waited out in the cold and then the rain for a little bit. Then we walked in. When you first walk in, after, of course, they give you your little bracelet and little book of the floor plan and all that stuff, you get a free bag. It's an IMATS bag. Kat Von D is on it. I found that the bag came in handy for holding all my different shopping bags that I got today. Today, my plan was to definitely go to Anastasia Beverly Hills and NYX because they were in the front, and those are two of my favorite brands, and last year, I remember those lines were ridiculously long, and I want to make sure I was able to go there first and get some products, but this year, I still did not go to either brand because even though we weren't that far in the line, that line was ridiculously long for both of them. I just didn't think that it was worth spending my time in the line for. On the other hand, I'm a huge Anastasia fan. Usually a lot of things that comes out for that brand, I just buy it as soon as it comes out. So I'm pretty sure there wouldn't have been anything that I really, really needed that I don't have or I couldn't have gotten later. So carrying on, the first place that we stopped, which was right behind Anastasia, was Juyer Cosmetics. I did go to their table last year and I think I did get more stuff. I got like a highlighter and some lip topping that they have, like the sparkly ones they could put over lipstick and make them look kind of iridescent. But this year I didn't go that far and buy that many things. What I did was I just bought one lipstick. They had a deal, I think it was like 3 for $35 and then 1 for $15. I would have made sense to get 3, but I was just not a fan of the other colors that I did not have. I got this new color, Noisette. These lip creams are really nice. They apply very nicely. And I will swatch it so you can see what it looks like. Very, very creamy. Actually, here, I'll like apply it to my hand again so you can kind of see. Hope that works. Yeah, there you go. Very creamy. I do like kind of like nude brown colors, so this was definitely something I had to get. It smells kind of like vanilla. It smells sweet, like icing or something, like vanilla icing. Moving forward, let's see. Next to them was a more smaller local brand, Talaro Cosmetics. I got my products in this cute little pouch. The owner was there. She was very friendly, very nice, explaining the quality of the products and that they're vegan. You know, they were also very affordable and things like that. So I had the chance to play with some of the products because the table wasn't that busy. I really liked their liquid lipstick and the color Soliciting. It's like a pinkish nude. I'll also swatch that for you. Right there. Oh, it's actually more pinkish. I'm sorry. Ooh. Yeah, but it's really nice. Very pretty color. And I got two lip glosses. They're called the lip candies. I really liked this color. Kind of like a rose gold in a way. It's very pretty. Rose gold, pink champagne, something like that. That's what how I would describe it. The owner was telling me that she gets the names from her friends. This name is Daddy Issues, the name of this caller. And I will put that right here. As you can see, very nice, very glossy. I should really like this one because it doesn't like have much of a color tint, so it's very nice, very natural if you don't want to wear a lot of makeup. And then this one, I really adored this color as well. You're going to see a lot of the products I got were like pinkish nudes. I'm trying to stay away from my trend of dark burgundy, reddish brown lipsticks because that's always what I tend to buy.
And this one kind of looks like soliciting in a way. It's just more of a glossy formula. And the soliciting one, it's starting to dry. That's good. And also in the little pouch, I got a little freak handcuff keychain. Very nice, very cute. I don't remember how much exactly the products were. I think the lipstick or the lip gloss something was $9. I didn't spend more than like $30 at this table, so I have to say it is very affordable compared to the other brands. And one of these days I will definitely try the product on all day to see like how I really feel about them. But I'm very happy with the color options that they have. After that, I didn't really plan on buying like any brushes or makeup removers or anything like that. But coming across, like, when I was walking by, there was a stand that sold, like, different, like, makeup wipes and makeup removers. And I didn't really look at that, but I noticed they had beauty blenders. And you can never have too many beauty blenders. They did have, like, the black, the purple ones, the pink ones. I saw that they had a white one. I never saw the white one in the store. I might be a little late on this, but these were actually cheaper than the black, pink, and purple ones. And you know, those sell at Sephora for like $20. These were $10 a piece. I actually got two, but I got one for one of my friends. $10 for a beauty blender, not bad at all. I know it's white, it'll definitely stain. Who gives this crap? You can wash it. So I thought that was a good deal. Next, I noticed MAC was nearby, and my plan was to not go to MAC, and that is because I felt like their line would be super long, and I didn't feel like there was any new product that I could get from them that was different than anything I've already had. But I did actually end up buying stuff. So at MAC, I got three different things. I got their strobe cream in glow. Oops. Gold light. Glow light. I mean, when you put on your face, you gotta be glowing. But anyways. And then I got two of the Retro Matte Liquid Lipsticks. But I got the more shimmery ones. The metallic ones, I think they're called. So I'm gonna open this. I did use this on my face. You may not be able to see it that much because I put a little concealer and powder on so I don't look like shit on camera. So I'll just put a little bit of this on my hand, rub it out, and show you what it looks like. So this product is basically like a lotion with like highlight in it. So you could either apply it to your face just as is. You could use it as a highlighter, or you can mix it in with your foundation, however you want to use it. That's the one thing I do like about MAC because a lot of their products are very versatile use. So this is what it looks like, me rubbing it out. See the sheen there? Very gold. I did like the peach one, but I think for my complexion, this was probably the best option. And they had a pink one. No. So, yeah. And it's very hydrating. It does really feel like a lotion, not greasy at all to me. I'll probably be using this a lot more in the summer. I don't really wear makeup a lot unless I'm going out, but this would be a nice thing to use. The next thing I got was the lipstick in the color Atomized. The color kind of reminds me, if you're just looking at it, kind of looks like a liquid version of heroin. I actually did not intend on buying any lipsticks, but the girl that worked there that was kind of like handling the line, she had this on her lips, and I really liked the color and how it looked on her. And she told me that they're actually selling this at the table, so I decided to get it. Although it's not a very common color to wear, like something I won't be wearing all the time, I still really like it. See, it's very pretty, very purple, and if you look very carefully, there's like a metallic kind of sheen in there too. Definitely something you could use if you don't want to have a lot of heavy eye makeup on, but you still want a pop of color on your face. And then I got this one, which is Gems and Roses. It reminds me of kind of like a rose gold kind of color. I like the color. I usually get very skeptical with really light nudes and pinks because I think they don't really look good on my complexion. But this, even if it's a little too light when I put it on my actual lips, I could use a darker lip pencil and it'll look fine. And that's the Gems and Roses right there. And I actually do like MAC's Retro Matte liquid lipsticks. I have a few at home. So yeah, that's what I got from MAC. The line there was actually very quickly, and they did have some good deals there as well. I think these were like maybe like $12 each. I'm not sure how much the strobe cream was. I don't really remember, but I thought it was worth the purchase. Right next to MAC was Lime Crime, and I really like Lime Crime. I love their Velveteen liquid lipsticks. The formula is very nice. Feels good on the lips, it stays, and they have a lot of different colors. So when we first got there, the girl made us sign up for a promotion, and when you sign up for the promotion code under their events page, you get a free gift thing, and I realized it was the unicorn hair dye. I don't have a problem with it. I just kind of wish it wasn't the Dirty Mermaid. I didn't have a choice in the color. So unless this washes out today, I am not going to be using this. But it's very nice of them. I also have a pencil that made its way into my bag. I'm going to open my Velveteen liquid lipstick in the color Sasha. Sasha's kind of like a rose nude matte color. So this is it. I'm actually really excited to use this. And I think that's just because I'm a huge Lime Crime Velveteen fan. Really like it. I didn't realize I got so many nudes on this trip to IMATS, and I usually don't wear a lot of nude lipsticks. And then I also tried out their plushies. If you're not familiar with these, which I was not until today, they're kind of like a lighter version of a liquid lipstick, kind of more like a stain. They stay on very well, feel very light. It's like a My Lip But Better product. I actually have both of these on right now. I mixed both of them, and I just had a huge sushi dinner and miso soup, and it's still there. So I'm happy. Very lightweight as well. I'm going to swatch each individually so you can have an idea of what they would look like without the mix. So this is the plushie in Lavender Honey. Yeah, I'm going to swatch it over here. So as you can see, very light. Right there. Right? And then, this is Turkish Delight. Nude color. Pretty in the tube. And I'll swatch that one right next to it. So yeah. I really like the packaging of it. It's like a nice clear box, clear pink box. Pink cap, a little teddy bear on it. It's very cute. I did get a free tote bag from Lime Crime. I forgot to pull it out, but that they gave the tote bag if you spent more than $65. I think I spent like $70 there. But these were not my only products that I bought. I got some stuff for my friends, so I was not paying $70 for just three things. So then we took a walk to the other side of the IMATS, I guess the whole convention area. And then, you know, we passed by the people that were like speaking on stage and stuff, and one of the places we were thinking about going to was Kat Von D, but I also didn't make it there either because that line was ridiculously long. And like I said, it's the same thing with Anastasia. Like, if it's something I really wanted, I probably have it already. And I'm sure they don't have anything that I don't have unless, you know, it's probably not something I really care for, because I probably would have waited in that line if I really wanted it. Moving forward, as we were walking around, we saw the line for Morphe. That line wrapped around the entire back area of IMATS twice. Morphe, I don't know. I thought it was the same thing, like mix. Like, it's already affordable. I didn't feel like I had to waste half my day waiting in line for a sale. But I did make it to BH Cosmetics. I really usually order brushes from them, and I wanted the Zodiac palette from them. So, lucky me, I was able to get it. So, this palette has, like, different color eyeshadows, and a highlighter in the middle, and a lot of like iridescent shimmery shades. So I'll open this and show it. This is it. Very, very pretty. Look at that. I'm going to swatch a couple of them, but obviously not everything. We would be here all day. The colors that stood out to me the most was Aries, obviously. I'm an Aries. So this is Aries. There. Wow.
Wow.
It's really, really pretty. And I also liked Cancer, which is like this purplish color down here. Oh my god, and the formula is very like nice and smooth. So I cannot wait to use these on my eyelids. Wow. This one's kind of like a periwinkle, I guess you could say. Bluish, lavender, purple. And I'm just going to do one more so we can get this moving. Aquarius also stood out to me right here. It looks kind of gold. Yellow gold. Okay. And that's Aquarius. Wow. I'm very pleased with the colors in here. This palette was like $22. I am going to say something. As happy as I was about my BH Cosmetic purchases, I went on the website earlier today because I got a brush set, the Rose Quartz brush set, and I wanted to look up reviews on it because I haven't actually like looked into that brush set, and they had pretty good reviews, 4.8 stars on one website, 4.6 on another, 5 on one. So I was really pleased about that. But then when I stumbled across BH website, their deals on their websites today, it was actually a lot cheaper than I met. So I probably could have skipped the table, but it's fine. They didn't have a line, whatever. I had the products in hand now. I didn't have to pay for shipping. So I guess that's a plus side. I'm going to open the brush set. I did use one of them to put on a little bronzer here. They're very, very This is how they come. More classic packaging. The brush set was like $17, I believe. I'm going to take out the highlighter brush. And I'm going to just swatch that highlight that's in the middle of the palette here, okay? Let's see. Okay, it's very sheer. I don't know if it's just not picking up here. But yeah, it's like very, very... Oh no, it's there. Not that sheer. It's there. I don't know if you guys can really see that, but... But yeah. It's there. So yeah, it's very nice. The brushes are really, really soft. The bristles are really, really soft. As you can see. And what drew me to them was this, the rose quartz color of the brush handle. I have tons of brushes. So even if some of them aren't that great, I'm totally fine with it. They're just going to sit pretty out of my vanity. But I haven't tried all of them yet. But I'm super excited, especially because the set is 9 pieces. And it comes with, you know, like your angle contour brush, which is what I used here. Then, you know, like your powder brush you could use for your blush. Highlighting brush. And then a couple of other brushes for the eyes. I'm excited for the blending brush. I love a good blending brush. Blending brush. Moving forward. Let me put that away. The Solar Flare palette. This also reminds me of like the iridescent shades that were in that one. They all have different like solar system kind of names. Different like... The shades are a very, like, warm tone. Let me open that for you. Wow. Look at that. Love those colors. I really love gold. Like, eyeshadow, every kind of makeup, highlight, everything. So, that's what drew me to this palette. Let me see. Let's see what colors I want to swatch. All right, so I'll do Orb over here. And the formula is very, very soft. Okay, wow, that is so pretty. And it blends out very, very nicely. I'm impressed. Fireball also stood out to me. It's like very orangey, obviously, with that kind of name. So let's see what it looks like on my hand. Wow. Super bright. But it would definitely stand out. You know, a nice pop to your eyelid. And I'll just do one more. Gamma Ray. I like purple. Purple's very pretty. And let's see what that looks like. Very nice. And it also blends very, very nicely as well. After BH Cosmetics, I wanted to go to Benefit. I love Benefit's eyebrow products, but I was very, very sad today because they did not have any eyebrow products in the colors 4, 5, and 6. And if you're familiar with the brand, 4, 5, and 6 are more like dark brown and black eyebrow colors. So unless you had really light brown eyebrows, you would not be able to find products there. So I was very upset about that. The guy tried to sell me a mirror. I did not go there for a mirror, so I was annoyed. But last year I went to get California and it was sold out. I knew I could have gone to the Sephora. I just completely forgot about it, but it brought back like a piece of nostalgia when I saw it last year and I wanted it, so I got it this year. And if you're not familiar, California is kind of like a gold pink corally blush, and Benefit always gives their little brush with the blush. Haven't used this yet, but I am now. I'm gonna see what that looks like as well. That's what it looks like on my fingers. And then on my hands. So yeah, it's very corally. I don't know if you could see that very well. But yeah, it's very pretty, very subtle. Kind of stands out a little bit because of the gold shimmer, but I think the pink is very nice. Big ass bag for one product. Alright. And last but not least, Too Faced. I went to Too Faced because their chocolate bronzers are the best ever. And I got the Born This Way concealer in the tan shade. Because I usually use the NARS Radiant Creamy Concealer. That's my favorite. I don't use anything else. But I wanted to try a new one. Which I did put it under my eyes. So I'm trying to play it with it. See if I like it. Keep it on for a little bit. See how it compares to the NARS. I've tried many. And I seem to not be able to leave the NARS concealer. Like, that is my holy grail. This is the concealer in tan. It does blend very nicely. However, I'm afraid I don't know what I look like on camera, but I hope it doesn't crease very easily under my eyes. And hopefully this will be a nice alternative to my NARS. We'll give it a few tries and see how we feel about it. What I did like was it's made with coconut water and rose, which are two of my favorite like natural ingredients that I like in my products. I usually use a rose water spray on my face and coconut water. I use coconut everything. My hair, my skin, etc. And then this is the chocolate gold bronzer. If you're not really familiar with their bronzers, the product is usually very good. Oh my god, I can't open this. Fidgeting. Okay, got it. There you go. So, it's made from 100% like real cocoa powder and real gold, apparently. There is shimmer in there. I hope you can see that. Smells like chocolate. I have it here along my cheekbones. I didn't go too harsh on my cheekbones. So I don't know if it'll really pick up in the video. Okay, and what I'm gonna use is the angle contour brush from the brush set that I bought, the BH Cosmetics brush set, to kind of put on my hand so you could see what it looks like. And just kind of glide it across the brush. I don't know how much you'll be able to see that. My hands are a lot darker than my face. But hopefully you're able to see it. But anyways, I love how the product goes on. It's not super dark. I don't know if this will be my favorite. It is very nice. And the reason why I say that is because I kind of prefer matte bronzers a little more. But I just really liked how this one looked in the packaging. So I had to get it. And I know that their chocolate bronzers are pretty good because I've tried a couple before. That's kind of everything that I bought. I did buy a few other products, but not for myself. For my friends. I'm a good friend. I like this for my friends. Let's see. I guess I could talk about a little bit about my experience there today. I bought a lot more stuff last year, I think. I think this year we were a little more smart about how we shopped. For example, the minute we got this book, we just opened it up to where the map is, and we kind of scoped out where we wanted to go. Certain brands we just skipped because they didn't really have a deal, and if the line was too long, we just said, forget it, it's not worth it. Like, you know, you already paid $65 to be there. I'd rather go and scope out different brands and get more deals and go to places that, you know, I can actually get my products and get going instead of standing in the line for like an hour, 2 hours, and having the risk of me waiting for a product that's not even there, or, you know, could be sold out or something like that. That's all we did. We didn't really go to the stages to listen to the speakers. We kind of just went for the makeup. Other than that, we were in and out in like 2 hours. I think that's all I have to really say for IMATS. I am looking forward to going again next year. Also, before I go, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to our page. I will also link the different brands of the products that I got. And that's it. See you next time.